Let us consider you may start at A point, you may start at B point, you may start at C point. For it is for convenience, let us consider battery positive terminal will provide a current I. Cell will provide a current I. As the current I go on traveling like this, Now once a current is distributed, here this is called current. Battery terminal, battery positive terminal, let us consider it drives the current I. As the I current go on traveling and reaches to the same negative terminal. Now, once you distribute the current, right, which point is the higher potential point, which point is the lower potential point? Which point is the higher potential point, which point is the lower potential point? Now, battery negative terminal is considered as a lower potential point. Battery positive terminal is considered as a higher potential point. Now, see the current direction. Now, current is traveling like this. What is the current direction? Higher potential to lower potential. Now, suppose the current is like this. Higher potential and lower potential. Suppose the current is traveling like this. This is the higher potential. This is the lower potential. Suppose the current is traveling like this. Higher potential point, lower potential point. Now, what is the current direction? This is the current direction. Current direction is left to right. Therefore, leftward point is called higher potential. Rightward point is called lower potential. Now, here in this case, How many closed loops are possible? Only one closed loop is possible. Right? One closed loop. What is the closed loop here means? A, B, C, D, A. Therefore, A, B, C, D, A. Therefore, this is called what to say loop direction. Now, this is also known as arbitrary direction. Right? This arbitrary direction is very important. You want to travel along the arbitrary direction. Now, in the circuit, how many cells are there? Only one cell, E. How many resistors are there? Only one resistor. Only one resistor means only one branch is there. Now, here what is the current? I. What is the potential drop? I into R is equals to 0. Now, in the closed circuit, how many cells are there? Only one cell whose EMF is E. Now, in the closed circuit, how many resistances are there? Only one resistance is there. One resistance is there means here across the resistance, what is the current passing through that one? I. Right? Now here in this case, what is the product of current and resistance? What is the product of current and resistance? I into R is the product of current and resistance. Now according to the sign convention. Right, before going to the sign convention, arbitrary direction is very important. What is arbitrary direction? A, B, C, D, A. A, B, C, D, A. Right, A point. Now, current, as we are traveling, right, A to B, higher to lower. Across the cell, A to B, higher to lower. As we are traveling higher to lower, it is taken as drop. Drop is taken as negative. Next, as we are traveling like this, arbitrary direction, now lower to higher. As we are traveling along the lower to higher, it is taken as potential rise. That potential rise is taken as positive, therefore IR is taken as positive. Therefore, on simplification, that is E is equals to IR. This is the application of Kirchhoff's second law. Now, first of all, a circuit is given. This is the circuit. In the circuit, see how many number of cells are there. How many resistors are there. Once you observe, next, right? Name the circuit A, B, C, D, right? After naming the circuit, distribute the current. Once you distribute the current, select any loop. The circuit may contain one loop, circuit may contain two loops, circuit may contain three loops. In the given example, how many loops are possible? Only one loop is possible, right? In that particular loop, how many cells are there? Only one cell there. How many resistors are there? Only one resistor. How many branches are there? Only one branch. How many IRs are there? Only one IR. Therefore, that is E is written as like this. The potential difference is taken as IR equals to 0. Now, what is our sign convention? Potential drop is taken as negative. Potential rise is taken as positive. Now, go through, that is arbitrary direction. What is the arbitrary direction? Right? A, B, C, D, A. A, B, C, D, A is the arbitrary direction. As we are traveling A to B, higher to lower. Higher to lower is taken as drop. Drop is taken as negative. As you continue to travel, that is lower to higher. Lower to higher, there is a potential rise. That potential rise is taken as, that is positive, IR is said to be positive. Therefore, now after simplifying, E is equals to IR. This is a simple application of the Kirchhoff second law. Next, I will take another electrical circuit. Now, what is the another electrical circuit? Now, let us consider. This is the cell, first cell. This is the another cell, right? Now, this is a resistor. This is the resistor. And there is another resistor. And there is another cell is like this. How many cells are there? Three cells are there. Right? E1. Right? E2. And E3. How many resistors are there? R1 and R2. Now here, in the given circuit, three cells are there. I1, I2, I3. How many resistors are there? Three cells are there. E1, E2, E3. How many resistors are there? R1 and R2. After observing, name the circuit. Therefore, this is called A. This is called B. Now this is called C, this is called D, E, F, right? Now, after naming the circuit, right, distribute the current, right? While distributing the current, take any point, right? The distribution of the current may start from this point. The distribution of the current may start from this point. The distribution of the current may start from this point. Let us consider now I1 is the current. As the I1 is the current traveling to the point D, I1 current is going to divide. As the I1 current going to divide, this is called what to say I2 current, and this is called what to say, right, I3 current. As the current is traveling, here I2, here is also I2 current. Here is also I2 current. Here is also I2 current. What is the current here? I2. And next one, right, here is the I3 current. I3 current. Here is also I3 current. Here is also I3 current. Here is also, what to say, I3 current. And I3 current is like this, right? I3 current is like this. What is the current here? I2. Here, what is the current like this? That is I3. I2 and I3 both are combined as a I1. Therefore, it reaches like this. Therefore, from the cell E2, there is a current I1. That current I1, at the junction D, it is going to divide I1 and I2. It is going to divide I2 and I3. Therefore, I2 current is traveling like this. I3 current is traveling like this. Therefore, here I2 and I3 both are going to combine to form as I and reaches the same current. Here at the point D, current I1 is going to divide I as I2 and I3. Here at the point C, I2 and I3 are going to combine as I1. Therefore, this is called current distribution.